Hello, people. How's everybody doing tonight? So this is like in here. I just realized I don't have my headphones on. This is the kind of a game where, like, at least with this part of my battle station, headphones on is much better. I've done other recordings where not having the headphones on is better because it's just less cables and tangle down here. Anyways, welcome to this set for Danganronpa 2. I think this is like 14 or something like that. We're getting in there. It's slow going because I'm taking my time. I'm exploring areas. I'm reading stuff. So, but that's perfectly fine. I'm not too worried about like how long it's taking me. But last time, I think we started the beginning of free time. I think I went and spent all of my Monokuma coins to get a bunch of presents. I didn't really get a lot of good presents. I mean, I think I got like, what, 2/3 were new presents, and like the other third was just stuff I already had. So, but we can deal with that. So yeah, allow me to bring up game audio. Needs to be, well, that's too high. Forty-five is too much. Can you not just literally land on 41? How did I move you down and you... I'll take it. That's the right number. Swap over here. And hey, this time it wasn't on the browser icon. Yeah. But still, we have options today. And this set's probably going to be a lot of going through free time and then getting to... trying to figure out, I don't know. Do we actually do that? Is that necessary? It just unlocked, so... now, you know what? We'll do all of that in one set towards the end, because I imagine there's going to be like two other things that come up because of that. Alright, so here's where we have to decide who we want to do free time with. I'm not sure if it's better to go for... I don't know if it's better to go for free time with people we haven't spent time with or people we have spent time with. Actually, you know what? First, I want to go to the hotel site. I want to see what it looks like. Well, okay, we're at free time, so there's actually two spots I want to go check. I still don't know what I'm doing with that, if I even care to do anything with it. Alright, we never got... can we go in? Oh, you're not gonna let me go in. I had assumed there was going to be something hidden in there. No. Alright. So we found out last set where they had tied everybody up. Why am I blanking on his name? I keep wanting to call him Nagy, but that's just not even right, even in the slightest. Nagito. I don't know why I keep fucking up the name Nagito. So I'm assuming they have him tied up in here. Nagito's tied up this one. I don't really want to see him right now. I'm not mentally prepared for it. I shouldn't go. I'm mentally prepared for it, damn it! Wow, you can just barely see the door when you do that. Alright. I don't think there's going to be anything here. So, I think... Alright, I'm going to need to look at my presents again. I think I have one for the princess. Because by talking to her in between the last sets, we found out she's a really big fan of, like... occult slash serial killer shit, and I think we have some of that. I think. That wasn't it. At least I thought so. Maybe we don't have anything for this. I could swear I had something for this. Well, I know who's gonna want that. Apparently, I thought I had some, like... I could swear I had something for occult people, but let's just go talk to the princess and see what we can get. Oh, I can't. This is the closest I can warp to, but that's fine. We might do Ibuki as well, just because we haven't really interacted with her all that much. At least not yet. Like, did I do something for her? I don't remember doing any report card stuff with her. No, I haven't done anything with her yet. Along with Mikan, which we might do some. We might try Mikan out because I have bandages. She might like bandages. I don't know. I guess we'll see when we talk to her. But first, let's talk to Sonya.
Good day.
Hi, Sonya. Oh my, Hajime. I was planning to go read at the library. Would you like to accompany me? Are we not at. We're. Sure, yeah, okay, fine. We're already at the library, but sure. Oh, God. I don't know if I was expecting that reaction from her. Then let us go forth. I'm looking forward to expanding my knowledge of serial killers once again. Sonya excitedly taught me some useless knowledge about serial killers. Actually, I just realized I'm also sitting a little further back. Let's fix that. That also means I gotta move my mic, remeasure. Should be, like, right. There is. I learned this trick. Just it should be roughly like four fingers out, but that's fine because I need to be closer to the screen. Because back here, I'm like, sure, it's fine back here, but I'm a little further back on the camera. So I'm fixing things. It's the first set of the day. I don't expect it to be perfect. Probably don't deserve it, but it looks like Sonya and I grew a little closer. Sure. Do I have anything that's like immediately off the top of my head? This is probably gonna be for Kyoko, if I had to guess. Well, no, I don't even know. Kyoko, I don't know. I had an idea about what I was gonna go with. I thought about going with this, but like, part of me doesn't think that's gonna actually be worth it now that I reread what it is. Maybe a food option? A food option might just be the easiest thing to go with at the beginning. I'm leaning towards the tea. Let's just give her the tea. Here, have some tea.
Open the treasure box and surprise!
May I really have this? Thank you very much. You truly are kind. Good, we got a good one! I must say, this island is truly a wonderful place.
Not tight.
The weather is calm, and the sea is blue. Truly a perfect resort setting. I mean, that's true, but...
Oh my!
Did I say something strange? No. I was just thinking that you're strangely calm right now. Sonya, are you really not worried about our current situation? Of course I am worried. I'm also angry. This is not something to joke about. Who's joking? It's not me. No, I'm not joking. I'm the one that's worried about this. What do you... Okay, yes. Fine. Nobody's joking.
However...
What happens next will depend on us. As long as we do not kill anyone, this will all be fine. That's the right attitude, but... Besides, I have come here to learn about your country. I would understand if this were my homeland, but in this case, this land is foreign to me.
Well?
I do not intend to kill anyone. And I do not intend to be killed easily either. The way she said that sounded kind of dangerous. If this were my homeland, so... Would this be okay in your country? Like, we don't know necessarily where Sonya's from. We just know she's not from Japan. And part of me imagined that if she's from some sort of royal family, they probably gave her some sort of self-defense training kind of stuff. And my phone is still on. Son of a bitch. I knew I forgot something. Of course the phone is on. Well, it's on, but it's nice and loud when it shouldn't be. Come on, phone. Come on. Why are you freezing up? All right. There we go. Sorry about that. But yeah, I figured they probably gave her some sort of martial arts training, some sort of self-defense something. I mean, she's gotta be able to protect herself. What happens if, like, the people who are protecting her can't get to her fast enough? So, that's where, like, oh, she needs to have some sort of self-defense, but... Anyway, let us forget about killings and cooperate with one another so we can return home quickly. If you have any good ideas, feel free to let me know. I shall also do my best to think of something, too. Yeah, you know what? You're right. When I speak to Sonya, I somehow feel really positive and optimistic. I'm also saying this out loud, because of the color of the text. Such an honor. Raise your head, there is no need to worry. What she's saying sounds odd, but she certainly looks the part. I guess that's typical of a princess. That reminds me, what was the name of your country? Oh, fuck me sideways. I'm gonna totally bitch out on this one. I'm pretty sure it's Nova Selec. I was right. I wanted to make sure, like, I'm trying to not lose, like, answer questions badly when I can get away with it, but I was right this time. Nova Select. It was the Nova Select Kingdom, right? It sounds as though you finally remember. Well, I mean, it's not really a country I've ever heard of before, and I know it exists out there somewhere, but... I mean, I guess, sure. It's there. It's out there somewhere. That is understandable. It is often overlooked by cartographers. Our Nova Select Kingdom is an extremely small country and governed by an absolute monarchy. Though the population is small, our economy is thriving, so we are not in dire straits at all. For generations, the royal family has protected the kingdom and its people from neighboring countries. And thanks to that, the people have complete trust towards the royal family.
Well?
Also, wine and chocolate is one of our country's hidden specialties. I see. You suddenly perked up when it's talking about wine or chocolate. Okay. It really does sound like a kingdom. Since you're the princess of that kingdom, does that mean you live in a castle or something?
Yes.
Of course! The royal family's been living in the royal castle for over 1,000 years. Though it may be old and small, the castle is truly a wonderful historic building.
Of course!
It's easy to see. It's easy to get lost in our subterranean labyrinth, and our barracks are fully equipped as well. Castles really do have those! Anyway, is it alright if I ask you something as well? I mean, if I can answer, it's fine. Sure, what do you want to know? Who did you have your heart set on initially? And who do you intend to switch to later? What? Huh? This situation is truly similar to the story of 7 men and women. I believe it's a standard tactic to start wavering and swapping partners. What kind of book did she read? Like, I understand that the numbers sort of equal out to that. I mean, we have roughly eight. Is it 8 and 8 we have? I think it's 8 men, 8 women on this island, I think. I might have counted the numbers wrong, but... what are you talking about?
Huh?
Do you really have no idea? It is Japan's legendary drama.
Well?
It starts off really upbeat, then it gets really serious. I never expected that to happen. I was all like, seriously, what is going to happen? I could just not take my eyes off the screen. Momoko's feelings at the time were... My goodness, so intense. I continued to listen to Sonya extensively talk about Japanese dramas. At least now, I totally understand that she's a major J-drama fangirl. Still don't have any skills. I'm wondering, like, if it's worth it to go for a character again to try to get another skill, because it's got to be something like on the third hope fragment, you actually get a... Yeah. You already get a, you get a skill that you can use. Because we have a bunch of levels. We just have no skills yet. After politely excusing myself from the long conversation with Sonya, I left the area. Right, because we have no skills, right? More free time. She has 37 skills, and I'm like, how in the sweet fuck am I supposed to get 37 skills? But yeah, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, no, it's 8 and 8. I don't know why I was like, wait, is it really 8 and 8? I can't remember if it was even the last game, too. Alright, I sort of know where I want to go. I just gotta figure out where Mikan's at. Alright, there's Chiaki. Okay, he's still there. He ain't leaving. Everybody's on the second island. Part of me expected Mikan to still be in the pharmacy. Huh? Wait, did I miss her? Hang on. Oh, so she's back. Okay. I did miss her. I was like, wait, what? What the fuck are we doing? Alright, let's go talk to Mikan. Like I said, part of me says I should be exploring other characters, but eh. Nido girl. Yeah. Never thought it'd be so calming to have someone next to me. Spent time relaxing in the park with Mikan. Looks like Mikan and I grew a little closer. Sure. I do have bandages. Why do you know what I wanted? I mean, you've got them like all over your arm and your leg and everything, so I just took a guess. Could you be Santa Claus? What do I do? I'm really happy. Thank you so much. Despite the fact that we decided to hang out, Mikan's acting suspicious and hasn't tried to look at me at all. Somehow I feel like I did something bad to her, even though I know I didn't do anything.
I'm sorry.
What's this all of a sudden? I thought you clearly looked like you were in a bad mood. Did I do something wrong again? What should I do? Would it make you happier if I took my clothes off? I mean, yes, but that's not necessary here. Hold on, why are you reacting like that? You're right. You don't want to see me naked, right? Then how about my money? You have money? Seriously, hold on.
I'm sorry.
It's no use. I feel like if I start panicking, the situation is going to get even worse. All right, I should just calm down first. Hey, Mikan, I don't want to talk to you normally. Talk? Today's such a beautiful day. Yeah. Why? What has happened to this girl in the past that is her immediate, like, Should I just take my clothes off? I'm sorry, should I take my clothes off? Seriously, you don't have to do anything like that. This is troubling. I guess I should start talking to Mikan about something she might get excited about. Probably bandage type. Don't you dare try to move that hand. Mikan, what type of bandage do you like the most? Bandage? Let's see, there's a lot of different types these days. It's extremely convenient because there are waterproof types and sticky types, but I definitely like the non-elastic types the best. Not too constricting, but they firmly secure wounds. Wow. I'm glad she looks like she's getting into the conversation. I'm sorry. I went ahead and started talking on my own. Don't worry about it. I'm the one who asked anyway. Also, I feel like I got to know you a little bit more. Really? Let's call it a day for now. It's not too much trouble for you. I'd like to talk to you again. It's been a while since anyone talked to me like this, so... Sure, of course, anytime.
Thank you very much.
We decided to go our separate ways for now, but for some reason I feel like Mikan was staring at my back for a little too long. She's not a bad person, but I don't really know how to communicate with her that well. Is there like a thing where I can go buy hope fragments, or I can use hope fragments to buy skills? Well, there went that free time. Alright, that's fine. Maybe in between sets, I'll look up something about skills, because I feel like...
Speak Academy School Trip Executive Committee has an announcement to make.
I feel like I either need to focus on people or do something else, because I'm not getting any skills. Like, last time in Danganronpa 1, I was able to get skills by this point and have them for the first trial. Not this game.
Emergency! Emergency! Students, head over to Jabberwock Park as fast as you can!
Oh boy. Here we go again. Monokuma's got something for me.
Whoever gets there first, I'll treat you to my special made curry rice tomorrow night! Come on, hurry the F up!
Curry rice, huh? It feels like... I haven't eaten that in a while. Wait, who'd actually fall for that? Oh, I actually know some people who'd fall for that. I don't know, what is he planning around this time? But there's no way I can ignore it. Jabberwock Park. Again, huh? Sorry, I'm such a slowpoke. I'll head over to the park right away. But I'm not being slow on purpose. I tried to leave my cottage as soon as I heard the announcement. I tripped again. I must get a lot of hate for making excuses like this. People are probably thinking, if you have time for that, then hurry up. Jesus, good God, woman. I gotta wonder what happened in her life to make her like that, but... Damn. Girl, she tripped again. Seriously, so pitiful. Or she's seriously so pitiful. What are you doing back here?
Damn it!
Why'd I have to listen to that announcement? Well, I didn't listen to it. I didn't have to respond to that annoying summons. It's kind of impossible. Those speakers are set up throughout the island, you know. Not only that, an excuse like, I wasn't paying attention won't work on a Monokuma.
Hey!
Why are you scaring me?
Damn it!
I don't wanna go. So he waited, he wanted someone to back him up so he could step forward. I sort of understand how that feels. I don't think there's anybody else over here. Does the map list where everyone is right now? So this is interesting. Nagi's not here. Or Nagi's still tied up. Okay, so it won't let me go in there, but it still lists him as inside. So. God, that is so hard to control. You'd think I'd be good at, like, with all the GoldenEye I played when I was a kid, you'd think I'd be good at circle strafing like that. Be able to, like, strafe sideways to go faster. But no. Oh, okay. Don't spam. Do you want to spam? Wait, there was a... Oh, fuck, I was on the... I just said don't spam circle. Or don't spam X. You want to spam circle when you're trying to cancel any upcoming text menus. Even though there's nothing on this... That will actually go by faster. Alright, let's go into the park. Alright, Monokuma, what do you got for me?
Yahoo!
I sort of figured Akane would be the first person to get here. Right? She's gonna be the one that if somebody's gonna promise her food, she's gonna be there first all the time, every time. I'm the first one here. The curry's all mine. She totally took the bait. Indeed, I wonder what kind of curry it is. You too?
Hey!
What's the scientific term for when you get hungry after you hear the word curry?
What are you saying?
You guys are fucking stupid. Don't get so worked up over something so idiotic.
Bastard!
Where the hell is Monokuma? Get out here!
Thank you for waiting!
Okie dokie, thanks for waiting! Thanks for the miracle of waiting.
Alright!
Hey, Monokuma! I was the first one here. That means I got the dibs on the curry.
What are you gonna do?
No need to rush. I'll properly treat you to my special made Monokuma curry tomorrow night. Mono Kuma curry?
What?
It's an extremely delicious curry made from unknown meat, wilted vegetables, and a mysterious brand of rice.
Hey.
I can't imagine anything delicious based on those ingredients. No worries, it takes skill to make curry nasty.
Good instincts.
That's truly a nice line, but it is meaningless.
You fiend.
Now, Mono Kuma, let us hear what your business is. I see an arcade cabinet over there. However, you should know I, the Supreme Overlord, have very little time to spare, understand?
Go, my four dark devas of destruction!
If this is something foolish, know that I will feed your remains to these beasts!
Wah-wah?
Huh? Huh? You haven't noticed yet? The reason why I summoned you guys, if you look closely at this park, you should be able to notice. Huh? Yeah, that. But we're gonna go left to right to get to see everybody. Seems Mono Kuma's up to something. What is he planning this time? Could it be? Maybe?
What's going on?
What's he planning to do this time? Isn't there a television-like object over there? I wonder what it is.
Wah wah?
You haven't noticed it yet? Yeah, we already know about that one.
Huh?
Curry, huh? Must be a demon, using the scent of curry to cause a chain reaction. People will feel like they have no choice but to eat curry. How horrifying.
Hey!
I agree with that. What's the scientific term for that, too?
Jeez.
Seriously, who the fuck cares? I see. You certainly prepared an intriguing tribute. I shall give you a pass on becoming food. What does he mean? Does this guy actually know?
Alright!
Might be pushy, but that curry's gonna be mine. She's very pushy.
Yes!
Kanin will do anything for food? She has a nose like a dog, so she might even run around in circles three times and bark. God damn, there's something wrong with that girl.
Man.
Just the name Mono Kuma curry makes my appetite drop to zero. In fact, it's in the negatives. Well, that's not that it matters to Akane. Her attitude is basically, I can eat it. It's good enough. Huh. On to more pressing matters. What kind of curry is it going to be? Earless seal curry? Stellar sea lion curry? Or perhaps it's actually bear curry? Why is she coming up with some questionable curry choices?
Oh my my!
What the heck is that? There's a TV over there. Is that curry? Is that the curry? Is it TV flavored curry? And of course, we have Mr. Standoffish bitch over here. Always fucking summoning us. Seriously, what is it this time? Twilight Syndrome. What is this? Isn't that an arcade machine?
Correct!
Yeah!
Thank you for waiting!
So, I would like the long-awaited recreation time to begin. Don't tell me you're gonna tell us to play this game. What is the game? What kind of games are on this? She's totally into it. She's breathing super fast. I've only prepared one game, but it's a true gem. After all, it's a game that I personally created. Wait, you made this?
Then?
It's not something I could possibly look forward to playing.
What the heck?
No. Don't compare those into those amateur fan service games.
Ding!
You know that famous game where everybody's been waiting for a sequel to? Well, I made a brand new game instead. Famous game?
I shall now present... Ta-da! The name of the game is Twilight Syndrome Murder Case.
Shit.
What the heck? That's pretty lame. I want to play games about riddle-solving professors or collecting cute monsters.
I know those games.
Stupid! Don't say such silly things. What if we get weighed down by all the quarters?
Twilight Syndrome is an adventure game series. The first one was released in 1996. It's about a group of high school girls who go exploring in order to verify numerous urban legends. The player controls the character like a side-scroller.
Meaningless.
I have no interest in weak things like video games. And I don't even know what generation a game that old is.
You.
With your face, I kind of find that hard to believe.
Boring.
But adventure games are so boring and tedious to play, right? Don't diss adventure games. Besides, there's tons of reasons to make one.
No.
You know, like budgetary reasons.
Aww.
Man, I was a big fan of that series. I don't know why, but I feel like you totally tainted the series.
What are you saying?
Shouldn't you be tainting your face with tears of gratitude? I've cast a spotlight on a neglected title. And what is the point of this game? Huh? I mean, it's not like you're gonna tell us to play it just to enjoy it, right?
Well done.
Ooh. You certainly noticed the good part.
That's right. This game is gonna be your next motive.
How the fuck is there a next?
The motive you need to kill people. After all, I'm gonna get bored if the next Blacken doesn't show up soon.
Could it be?
This game is the motive?
Actually.
In truth, this game's theme is a missing link. You know, it's a recurring theme for mysteries, right? It's kind of like a hidden connection. What does that mean?
Here!
If you're interested, then try playing it. Okay.
Hey!
You can't. You gotta say no. It's a trap.
Hey!
Hey, if that's the motive, won't it be okay if we just don't play it? That's absolutely right. You're quite the genius. Oh, I see. That never occurred to me.
Are you sure about this?
Are you sure you want to do that?
Hey.
Learning the motive means you're going to be prepared, you know. Humans who are prepared and humans who aren't. I don't have to tell you which is strong and which is weak, right? What do you mean? Yeah, for example, if someone secretly played it, that person might come and kill you.
Watch out!
In the context of a preemptive strike, it's truly fatal.
Hey!
What do you mean? You guys are all enemies, you know? Is it really all right for your enemy to have an advantage? If you're gonna ignore it, then do whatever you like. Even if you're fully aware of the situation. Bye-bye! What the heck?
This is bad.
Hey, what should we do?
But...
Even if you ask me, there's no way I'll know.
Anyway...
It would be dangerous to carelessly touch this game. There's no mistaking that.
You are right.
It might be better if we wait and see how this plays out.
But...
Wouldn't it be bad if someone secretly played the game while we were waiting? Whoever gets the motive would become the hunter, and the rest of us would be the prey. That's a messed up way to think about this.
What are you saying?
But it's true. It's your loss if you end up dying. All we need to do is kill if we want to win. I don't want to end up like Byakuya or Teruteru. After Fuyuhiko spat those words, we watched him turn and walk away.
But
Fuyuhiko makes a good point.
Huh?
You too? What are you saying? Do you really want to kill someone that badly?
Cause...
It's not like that. I mean, how can you be cautious if you don't even know the motive? That might be true, but...
Nope.
Doesn't matter. What? Motive or otherwise, it doesn't matter. I won't let another killing happen.
I'll never allow it.
Ever let another killing happen. Nighttime?
Ahem! Hope Speak Academy School Trip Executive Committee has an announcement to make. It is now 10 p.m. Please return to your rooms and relax. Let the sound of the ocean gently rock you to sleep. Now then, sweet dreams, everyone. Good night.
Huh?
It's already that time, huh? better if we just break for today.
Hmm.
I'll try to think about it tonight more carefully. The correct thing for me to do.
But...
regardless, I will never kill anyone. I mean, it's impossible. Me too. It's definitely impossible.
For now.
Well, we should just turn in for the day. I'll see y'all tomorrow. Burdened by uneasy thoughts, we all went back to our respective cottages. But still... it was totally unexpected. I can't believe she actually said something like that so forcefully. I will never, ever let another killing happen. She's probably dealing with all of this in her own way, but...
sleepy.
I feel sleepy. I should go back to... I really can't read her at all. Motive to kill someone, huh? Is doing nothing correct at all? Or is trying to stop it from happening while being aware of the danger correct? There's no way I'd understand something like that. And sleepy sleep. In this messed up world, there's no way I can know what's right.
This is troubling.
You don't know how tough it is to be successful. So jealous of people who aren't successful and don't have anything. The biggest obstacle to challenging new things is definitely your past successes. Those always hold me back all the time. I'm so jealous of people who don't have anything. People with no expectations sure are happy. I mean, they can do anything they want without worrying about anything.
That's all from Monokuma Theater.
Man, being successful is tough. I should crank the fan in my room.
Trip Executive Committee has an announcement to make. Good morning, everyone! Looks like today is going to be another perfect tropical day. Now then, let's show some enthusiasm and make sure to give it our all today.
I should go to the restaurant for now. As if by habit, I left my cottage, and I just so happened to bump into a certain someone.
Huh?
Oh! It's you, Fuhiko. How unlucky. I have to see your face this morning.
Hey, bastard!
Just so you know, I don't want to talk to you at all. I'm in a really bad mood right now. It's not like you're going to the restaurant now, right? Were you planning to go somewhere else?
Shut up!
Like I said, I don't want to talk to you. I'm gonna go back to my cottage. Just leave me alone. You say you're going back. Did you go somewhere?
It's got nothing to do with you.
Hey, I didn't tell you. Didn't I tell you? I don't want to talk. Is it that game?
What?
What do you mean? So it's true. What do you have in your hand? Hey, what's that envelope? What's inside? Shut up! What makes you think you have any right to question me? I'm not trying to question you. I am trying to question you, but I'm not trying to question you. I just want to know what the fuck you have. You little bitch. I feel like he's the kind of person that you could just bait him into being like, oh, you're too scared to show me the information. It's too bad. Everybody's gonna know you're just so afraid to show what you have. It's not cool, man. I was just... Are you saying that you don't like the fact that I acted on my own without consulting you guys? Is there something wrong with that, huh? Are you gonna tie me up like Nagito? Seriously, we might. If you're gonna keep acting like the little bitch you are, but... I didn't mean...
Dumbass!
Don't ever talk to me again. If you do, I swear I'll fucking get you. We should just tie his ass up and be done with it. That guy, he's gonna be dangerous if we leave him alone. I should let everybody know... but I should be careful not to make too much trouble. It's Gundam.
This too, must be the will of causality.
The wind is very quiet. I do hope it is not an ominous potent. Oh, nobody else is outside, huh? I guess we check the lobby because there's more than likely two or three people in here.
Well?
Apparently Mikan has never played video games before. She's totally missing out on like 90% of her life. Well, you know, values vary from person to person.
Hajime!
Please listen to this! What? Jackie taught me how to play a video game. She was so nice and attentive, and she even battled against me. I was so happy. I was able to play with a friend. Thank you very much, Chiaki.
You think so?
You don't have to thank me that much. I had a lot of fun too.
Hey.
Hey, I mean, if you like, do you want to battle one more time? Yes, please. Mika looks extremely happy. I guess Chiaki has a sweet side too. No hidden bears in the room anywhere. I don't think they would, you know, hide a bear in an area we've already cleared, but... Nice timing. I've been waiting for anybody to come by at a time like this. Waiting, hey. Huh? I was thinking about delivering this. Is that someone's breakfast? Oh, is that for Nagito? I mean, if we leave him all tied up, he's gonna starve. Like, how long are they planning to continue this? Well, there's no way we can keep him tied up forever.
Aww.
Yeah, that's what I thought at first, but maybe it's better if he was tied up forever. What do you mean by that? What? I mean, I actually went to see Nagito earlier. I kindly brought him breakfast.
Jeez.
And listen to this. He seriously pissed me off.
Do you understand?
He said he doesn't like rice, so he wanted toast instead. He doesn't understand the situation he's in right now. So that's why you're running back and forth. That must be kind of hard for you.
Really?
Hard? Do you really think so?
Hey!
Then bring this to Nagito on my behalf. Wait, what? Me? Really? Why?
Jeez.
I was forced to run back and forth so many times. I'm done being his maid. And not only that, I just remember that I have a little business to take care of. Everybody's going to that fucking arcade cabinet, aren't they? Business?
Thank you.
Thanks. I'll leave the rest to you. Mahiru pushed the tray into my hands and ran away before I could object. Jeez, it's always something. As I recall, he's tied up at the old building where the murder took place, right? Okay. That's Nagito's food, right? You should feel honored that Mahiru asked you to bring that to him. So you better feed him quickly. She says that like he's a pet. It's kind of trash. Or kind of harsh. Trash, harsh, sort of both. Hey, what are you doing? You kind of forced this on me, you know.
Hey!
Don't say I forced it on you. You're the one who agreed to do it, right? No. I agreed to do it after you decided to shove it in my face and leave.
Jeez.
Anyway, I have some things to do, but Yoko said...
Jeez!
Hajime, you're in the way. Mahiru and I are going to go to the supermarket right now. We need candy for each other, right?
Hey.
I know. Don't cling to me like that. It's hard to walk, you know.
Hey!
Can we still hold hands? Of course.
Hey.
But I really can't spend too much time with you. I have some things I need to take care of.
Aww.
So boring. Let's ditch Hajime already and
Thank
go.
You.
Well then, Hajime, I'll leave it to you. Hyoko's totally attached to Mahiru. They kind of look like sisters. I mean, it doesn't look like Hyoko has had many people who were nice to her. Man, someone like me to sleep in.
Huh?
Oh, what's with that tray? Are you going to eat somewhere with a nice view?
Hey.
Don't tell me.
Hey!
You're not gonna have a picnic lunch with Miss Sonya, are you? What if I am, motherfucker? I mean, no, of course not. It's not even lunchtime. This is breakfast for Nagito.
Well...
I see. Sorry to trouble you with taking care of him. I mean, if you really mean that, when you want to switch with me?
Hmm.
I mean, it's a little awkward. I'll let you handle it, Hajime. He totally just ran the fuck off. Alright.
You can't!
No. This old building is being renovated. You can't go inside. If I'm not allowed inside, why is Nagito inside?
Ooh.
You know about it too, Hajime? Because Nekomaru and Kazuichi earnestly told me that Monomi's the only one we can rely on. Oh my god, they really fucking manipulated her. It's true, Nagito needs to reflect on his actions. I came here to deliver food to Nagito. It counts as murder if he ends up starving to death, right? It's okay to go inside then.
Ta-da!
Yes, fine, whatever. Just make sure you tell him to chew thoroughly before he swallows. Oh boy, so Nagito's tied up at the back. Instinctively, I gulp back my dried saliva. Why am I so nervous? Pushing aside my nervous tension, I vigorously open the door to the dining hall. As I quietly peek through the door, I saw him on the other side. He was waiting for me with a big smile on his face.
Hajime? Could it be... Did you take time out of your busy day to bring some food to little old me? Wow, I'm so happy. As you can see, I can't exactly greet you with my full hospitality, but feel free to relax.
He was the same as usual. Unlike his smile, his words carried a certain heaviness, as if a black poison was falling from his mouth every time he spoke, filling his surroundings with darkness. An illusion, but one I couldn't help feeling that at that moment.
What happened? Your face looks kind of scary.
I mean, this is kind of a grim fucking situation, sir.
I didn't come here to talk to you. I just came to bring you some food. So come on, eat it.
You're not going to feed me.
What do you mean?
Well, I can't eat it on my own. You know, since my hands are all tied up.
Are we gonna have to feed this motherfucker?
Actually, I was really embarrassed to ask a girl to feed me, so I'm glad you're the one who came.
Oh, I get it. Friggin' Mahiru. That must be why she asked me to go instead of her.
Anyway, what happened to Mahiru? She leaves saying she had some business to take care of?
Yes, in fact she did.
Huh? Why do you know that?
By the way, I heard about... Twilight Syndrome murder case, was it?
Who's been talking to you about that?
I have mixed feelings. I really like that game a lot.
Don't change the subject. I'm asking you...
Did he get loose and go play it?
Oh well, I'm a little disappointed. It's not like you Ultimates to ignore the threat that's standing right in front of you. So are you really planning not to play the game? Do you think Monokuma will just let that slide?
Well, that is...
You guys should confront it. After all, hope springs when you confront despair.
He almost sounds reasonable. Running away from your problems isn't a solution. I'm just putting it off. But
I don't want to be tricked by you anymore. Bye now.
Hey, Hajime. Weren't you planning to feed me? Hey, Hajime!
Damn it, I barely talked to him, and now I'm already not feeling well. But I really can't stop thinking about it. Is it really okay to leave that game alone? Well, I'm doing nothing about it. Somebody else is. No, nothing good can come from thinking about it. There's something else I need to do. Free time. I didn't realize we were going to get another free time segment here. You know what? This is actually not a bad spot to end this set. It'll be right at the beginning of another free time segment. We've got a little bit of story. There's some weirdness. I have no idea what's going on with this game, but I imagine we'll find out in the next set. We have more free time. I don't know who we're going to go for. We'll figure that out, and we'll worry about that later. Oh, God, excuse me. But yeah, that's it for this set. Thank you guys for joining me for this. If you enjoyed yourself, do me a kindness. Like, comment, subscribe, all that goodness. You can also follow me on Twitch, where I broadcast live during the week. If you want to see me record live and stuff like that, the link is in the description down below. You can also check out my Twitter account, which I'll post random shit up there every once in a while. I'll like random memes, whatever I feel like actually is good. Sometimes I tweet about stuff. It's there if you want to check it out. The link to that is also in the description down below. We're gonna get some more sets done today. I don't know how many I'm gonna record today, but I'm gonna try to record a bunch to try to get a little further ahead. I don't know where I'm gonna end up at, but we'll see. On that note, I'm gonna get out of here. Before I head out, I need you guys to do me a kindness. I want you to have a good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night, good day, whatever it happens to be, wherever you are at. And I will see you guys in the next set. Later.